A film with an ISO of 3200, in all honesty, does not have the widest range of applications as compared to many of its counterparts. This is why, since shooting two-thirds of this roll of Delta 3200, it's been three good months before I found another situation that would warrant such a high ISO value to complete the remaining frames.
The time is now approaching 8. How it's still so bright at this hour. I originally intended to reserve this roll film specifically for nighttime photography, and I think we do still have some time before it gets completely dark. I'm just gonna get started right now.
I so badly wish I could play more of the singing and the music. There were some of the greatest hits of all time, like ABBA's Dancing Queen and much more, which obviously are copyrighted material. Either way, late May was when the UK reopened, with most restrictions lifted in over a year. People everywhere were ecstatic. All the energy, the cravings, and emotions were let out after a long, long hiatus. A guy was getting married, so his buddies threw him a party, a fishy one. As it got darker, the lens was struggling to focus, thus the noise.
We are now at around 9:30. I feel like I've been shooting just like how I would otherwise shoot in broad daylight. Perhaps the ISO of 3200 is quite a lot, even for lighting situations like these. Technically, it's still blue hour right now. And so let's do some more testing when it actually drops into complete darkness.
With film photography, I'm usually more cautious when it comes to shooting through glass. Reflections, while they can appear quite bright, are actually much darker than the actual thing. While it might not feel so to the eye, the reflections are prone to being underexposed on film. But that should not be an issue here. Thank you. As usual, here are some of my thoughts after shooting on this roll of Ilford Delta 3200. The first thing that I definitely have to mention, although it's almost become a cliche, is that the grain is super noticeable. I've read quite many reviews online about that, and there certainly is no question to that. But now the question becomes whether or not that's a look that you're looking for. For me personally, while I am open to shooting on this film stock again in the future, right now I do not see a compelling reason as to why I would want to work with this film stock. Based on the previous body of work that I've created, this set of images might feel a little out of place. Let me know what you think, but I personally think that it's not really sitting comfortably with the other photos that I've created. So I don't have anything against the film stock per se, but it's an important consideration in choosing a film stock that it matches with the general vibe or style that you shoot in, so that you present yourself as an artist who is consistent in what they create. Another thing that I've also noticed is the lack of shadow detail. This obviously has a lot to do with how you metered for the shot, and also practically how dark the scene was when you were shooting. As I've just showed you, for me, I've shot the first two-thirds of the roll outdoors, starting from after the sun has set all the way as the night descends. As to the final one-third of the roll, I actually shot it indoors also at night of a house party, which I choose not to show in this video. But looking at the images overall, I do think that the shadows tend to look a little bit muddy. What I'm certainly not saying is that photos have to have a ton of shadow detail. If a situation comes up where it's sensible for you to do so, by all means, crunch that shadow and leave out the detail, drop them into absolute blackness. However, again, it has to do with my personal style of shooting. That's not really a look that speaks to me personally. Also, this is where the option of digital photography kicks in. As a person who shoots a great deal on digital as well, if I knew that I was gonna shoot at night and that it was going to be a low light situation, I do have some reservations as to why I would ditch digital, which is obviously more versatile when it comes to low light, and go for instead the ISO 3200 film, like I did in this instance. So now there's an added consideration in relation to this film. Now that said though, based on my research on this film stock, I'm aware that there are a ton of tricks that you can do in relation to shooting on the Delta 3200. Not only do its supporters say so, its manual tells us that it's actually fit for shooting at a relatively wide range of ISO values. Since I've only shot using box speed, I'm probably missing out on something that the film has to offer, which is something that I'm definitely down to trying in the future. Also, looking at these photos, another idea that I have at the top of my head is that I might want to try to shoot something that's closer up. So, for instance, a portrait. In many of these shots, I have shot from afar, so many of these subjects took up really small parts of the frame. Naturally, the smaller something appears in a frame, the less potential it has to hold detail. And in order for a scene to look natural, especially in black and white, shadow detail is crucial. In the future, I am open to trying this roll of film again, this time shooting something that's more closer so that it takes up a larger part of the frame and that it has more potential to retain detail, which, as I hypothesize, would give a more natural look to the photos. All of the photos from the above section will be put in a slideshow in the end. Again, thanks so much for watching, and see you next Saturday. Bye!